sneaky feet either. But it wasn't really, the point wasn't sneaky feet. The point was that the burning bush helped Moses find his guide, which was God. Okay, so who is our guide? Yes, ma'am. I'm your guide. No, I'm not the guide for your life. I'm your guide for this camp right here. But who is it? Let me see. We just sang a song that's filled out a second ago. Jesus. That's right. That's right. It was Jesus. So Jesus is our guide. And today, we're going to have another special helper who's going to talk to us about following our guide. Now, can anybody tell me, when you're in the wilderness or, you know, in the forest, whatever you want to call it, and you get lost from your group, can anybody tell me what you're supposed to do? Scream help. Well, that's kind of true. That's kind of true. Andy, what do you have to say?
Stay put.
Stay put. That's right. Both of those are true answers. In the industry, we call it hugging a tree. Okay? That doesn't mean you actually go up and put your arms around a tree. What that means is you stay in one spot. And then you're going to holler out for your guide, whoever that might be. It might be your mom and dad. You might say, "Dad!" And then you wait a little bit, and you say, "Mom!" And then you wait a little bit, and you say, "Dad!" But what you don't do is you keep wandering around, because you know what happens? They can't find you, because you're not where you're supposed to be. That when we lose someone, when I'm a guide and I lose someone, the first thing we do is we go back to where we know they was. And then we start to look. So now just remember what we talked about, because later on tonight we're going to talk about the same thing a little bit further. Now we got a special friend tonight, but I heard a rumor. I don't know if this is true. We may have to be careful tonight, because I heard that our special camp helper tonight, a little bit drunk. I heard he was not very, well, he just wasn't a happy camper. So, hopefully, we can get him to come out and talk to us and tell us a story. And hopefully, he won't be too mean. So, let me hop up here. Uh-oh, I've got to find my Bible. I lost my Bible. It's on the stage. There it is. I can't lose that. So, Mr. Pillar of Flame, are you home? Hello? Grumpy?
Hello?
Why are you unhappy? I heard you were unhappy. Is that true?
Yes, I'm very unhappy.
What's the matter?
I don't like my job at all.
You don't like your job?
Seems like a pretty good gig to me.
What is your job?
Well, at night, I lead the Israelites.
Okay. Well, what's wrong with that?
Well, the thing is, during the day, a cloud takes my job, and I don't like that at all.
Oh, he sounds a bit jealous, doesn't he?
I am not jealous.
A little insecure?
Nope.
You a little insecure? You think the cloud might be more important than you?
Maybe.
So, I think you have a pretty important job. So, do you have a story to tell us?
Yes, I do.
Well, let's hear your story and you know, try to make it through without crying. I know you seem to be a little sad about your whole plight in life.
I'm not a crybaby.
Okay, that's good. So what kind of story do you got?
Okay, are you ready for it?
I'm ready. Are you guys ready? Are you guys ready to hear a story?
Yeah!
We've been waiting to get done with your whining so we can hear your story.
Okay. Well, it starts out like this. At night, I lead the Israelites by a blaze of fiery glory. And then the cloud takes my job.
Where were they going?
To the Promised Land.
The Promised Land. Where are they coming from?
Egypt.
Egypt? Yes. Ain't that where Moses was supposed to be going yesterday?
Yes, that's where Moses.
Okay. So was Moses with you?
Yes, of course.
Okay. So how many people were you guiding? How many people were you leading?
600,000.
600,000. Are you sure about that?
Pretty sure.
Pretty sure. Did you count them?
No.
Okay. 600,000. How many? 600,000. You must be pretty bright.
Yeah, I'm brighter than the burning bush.
Oh.
That ain't fair. I heard you say it.
Okay, so now there's 600,000 people and Moses. You're going from Egypt to the Promised Land?
Yes.
And how long does it take you to get there? How long does it take you from Egypt to the Promised Land?
It takes about 40 years.
40 years? How far is it from Egypt to the Promised Land? That's a long time. Did you crawl? Did you make the people crawl?
No.
Okay. So, what was you, so at night you just came up and showed them so they could see where to go? That was your only job?
Yep.
That's your only job?
Well, I'm also there to show that God is always there for them.
Okay. So you're kind of like God's representative.
Yeah.
So the people knew that God was always with them.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Is that all you have to say?
Yep, pretty much.
Pretty much. Well, that's a pretty good story. You know, that story of your brightness out there in the wilderness reminds me of something. It reminds me of a story in here. Let me just turn over here to the book of John. And we're going to look at chapter 8 and verse 12. And Jesus again spoke, saying, I am the light of the world. He who follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. You know, those people that was following the burning bush, they seen light all the time, even when it was darkness. Just like as our guide, Jesus, if we follow him, we will always be in the light, even when darkness is around us. And the Bible will talk about light. Does anybody know what light represents in the Bible? No? Light represents goodness. And darkness represents what?
Evil.
Evil, that's right. So even when there's evil around us, if we're following our guide, Jesus, we will be in the light. We will always see him. So we need to remember to always follow our guide. When we follow our guide, we will get to where we're going. We will get to our promised land if we follow our guide.